Hey guys, so you can tell just by looking at me that I am Korean, or at least Asian. If you don't know what Korean is, I'm South Korean, just so that you know, you're not going to ask, if you ask, what part of Korea are you from? South Korean. If you don't know where that is, it's this small peninsula country sandwiched between China and Japan, okay? I hope you at least know what Japan and China is. I'm Korean. I was born there. I grew up there until I was 10 years old, and then I came to the United States. I am currently a permanent resident, but at one point, my family and I became undocumented status for about 6 months, or as conservatives would like to call me, illegal. Yeah, I was illegal for 5 months, right? Don't really like that term for immigrants who don't have the permanent resident status. I do prefer the term undocumented residents. Anyway, in any case, yeah, I'm Korean. I'm not a U.S. citizen. But pretty soon, I will be a Korean-American. Or just American, actually, because I will be renouncing my Korean citizenship. I'm going to be a U.S. citizen very soon. So I just thought to do a few videos just kind of talking about the process, my process. So it's my story of becoming a U.S. citizen. But before I get into the process and the nitty-gritty of anything like that, I'll just kind of address probably the first question that comes to mind, which is why? Why even become a U.S. citizen? Why not just continue being a permanent resident or stay Korean-American or wait for longer and try to get a chance to do a dual citizenship? I don't know. The why question is always asked for whatever. Anyone does anything, the first response people are going to say is, why? Why the hell did you do that? You know, why are you in grad school? Or why did you get that loan? Why did you buy that car? Why did you buy this tie? Or where did you, it's always a why. Why is the first thing on people's mind? Why was this universe created? Why do you live your life? What is the meaning of life? A lot of why questions. For the U.S. citizenship, I definitely know the answer to the why. There's two reasons. Reason number one, to not be in the Korean military. Because Koreans get drafted. And I would be drafted. There's way out of that since I'm living here in this country, in the United States. So, I'm a permanent resident here, which gives me the option to extend my drafting period, which I did. So because I'm a permanent resident, they wait till I turn 25 to request that I join the Korean Army. I turned 25 and then I filed this extension. Now I'm given till I'm 35. So after I turn 35, Korean government is gonna be like, Eutim Kwon, that's my legal name. Eutim Kwon, you need to come to the United States. You need to leave the United States and come to Korea and join the military because you're being drafted. That's what's going to happen. And then I'm not sure what the process would be. Do I request another extension and not go? Or I'm not sure how that happens. But as a permanent resident, there is still a chance that I can be drafted into Korean military. I don't want to be drafted into the military. No. Don't want to be in the Army or Marines or Navy or anything like that. I'm a pacifist. So only of the last resort, if all my career options fail and I'm just like, okay, I should probably go to the Army because that's where the benefits and pay are, the only way I could do stuff. Yeah, then I would go. The last resort. But right now, things are okay. I don't have to do that. And I don't want to do that. So definitely, number one of the reasons why I'm becoming a U.S. citizen. Second reason is to change my name, actually. So through the U.S. citizenship process, I can change my name to something that's... my legal name is Eutim Kwon. So it's spelled very weirdly. My parents did a really awful job of spelling my Korean name into English, because Korean, it doesn't use Latin alphabets, it uses Korean alphabets. And the sounds in Korea, the sound that exists in the Korean alphabet doesn't exist, some of them don't exist in English, and vice versa. And my name happens to have Korean sounds that doesn't exist in English. So spelling it out is a challenge. My parents did it this way. They spelled it E-U-D-D-E-U-M. When most people see that, they pronounce it as Eudeum, which is not my name. My name is Eudeum. Now, Eudeum, to get that correctly, is extremely hard. So even if I change my name that is better spelled, it's still going to be inaccurate in a way. But I'm going to spell it to be better, E-T-H-M. So it's going to be Eudeum, which is closer to Eudeum. You know, it's better than Eudeum. Now, why did my parents spell it that way? Because they thought combining the consonants, combining the vowels E and U would make the U sound, which it doesn't. Because in Korean, combining vowels actually makes new sounds. In English, they don't. So, that's a mistake. Also, in Korean, if you put two D sounds together and make a double D, that makes a TH sound, D. In English, you put two D's together, that does nothing. So that's why my name is spelled E-U-D-D, supposed to be TH sound, not a D sound, E-U-M. But anyway, I'm changing my name to David. That I want that to be my legal first name. And then I'm going to be Eudeum, is going to be legal middle name. And then Kwon. So the reason is because people know me as David. Almost everyone does. So it's easier. On my high school record has me as David, my college record has me as David, so it would be much better for me to be known as David, and then have my middle name be Eudeum, my first given Korean name. I think it's important to keep that name because that the meaning of that name, and I'll make another video about my name in general, has kind of motivated me to come to this point. There's a lot behind my name, and I want to keep it. But I want it to be spelled better than my original spelling. And I don't, you know, my parents didn't do it out of ill will. They just didn't know the English language all that well. So I don't, you know, I'm not angry at them. I'm just baffled by the spelling of my name is all. Third reason is I want to join the Peace Corps. And you can only join the Peace Corps if you're a U.S. citizen. At some point in my life, I want to do Peace Corps. I think it's going to be an amazing experience that I gained so much from. And if when I come back from doing 3 years of Peace Corps work, I will come back with a lot. And I think I'll have all these ambitions that I'll be able to kind of be able to start achieving with that kind of experience. And who knows, I might find the love of my life in Peace Corps. Apparently, a lot of people find their wives or husbands in by joining Peace Corps. That's not the reason I want to join Peace Corps, but who knows, that could possibly happen. Who knows? But those three reasons are really it. I don't really, you know, I'm not becoming a U.S. citizen because I'm a American patriot or something like that. Don't really have a very good nationalistic sense. I'm not really that tied to Korea. I'm really not that tied to America. A country is a country, you know, and people live in it. That's pretty much it for me. I think the interesting perks are being able to vote. I think that's going to be a pretty cool perk. It's an important perk. Not the major reason why I'm becoming a citizen. And also being able to serve in the jury, I think is going to be pretty cool. There's many benefits and rights that come with U.S. citizenship. And I'm excited to get to kind of chance to be able to exercise those rights and benefits. But for the most part, the major three reasons I'm becoming U.S. citizens is to not be in the Korean military and to change my name to something that is spelled more accurately and to join the Peace Corps sometime in my life.